Hey, hey, it is Q&A Tuesday. That means I am logging in to the BeyondFit Life members group on Facebook and I'm taking your questions. So each week I'm gonna log in, I'm gonna grab a question that you post and I'm gonna answer it for you via video. So today's question comes from Monica and she asked, what's up with hormones? How can you balance hormones for fat loss? This is a great question. And if I went in detail on everything that you need to do to balance your hormones for fat loss, I think we'd probably be sitting here for like a couple hours. So let me break down and kind of give you the short story on fat loss and why hormones matter. For fat loss, calories in and calories out is not the whole picture. So obviously we know that training and nutrition both play a role in fat loss. This is looking at the calories in versus calories out model. Nutrition, you can adjust the calories that you're eating, right? To get you closer to your fat loss goals. For training, you can burn calories, again, adjusting the calories in versus calories out, and that also is gonna get you closer to your fat loss goals. But one missing piece of the puzzle comes in the component of our hormones. Hormones absolutely matter. You have to have a caloric deficit, but you also must have balanced metabolic hormones in order to optimally burn fat and to make fat loss a lifestyle. So, a couple of ideas for hormonal balance. First, you need to make sure you're doing the right type of workouts. Long duration, moderate intensity cardio actually raises stress hormones and it's gonna make your fat loss more difficult. So you wanna be doing quick, high intensity exercises with weight training, sprints, that sort of thing, like our BeyondFit Life workouts, right? Because these exercises, this type of training actually increases your fat burning hormones. So that's one way you can adjust your hormones, the type of training that you do. Another kind of note regarding training, in addition to increasing fat burning hormones, you also want to decrease stress hormones. So stress hormones are actually gonna cause you to store a little bit of fat. So ways you can decrease stress hormones are things like yoga, getting enough sleep, restorative activities like leisurely walking. This is gonna lower cortisol and set yourself up for a more balanced hormonal environment. Another idea when we're talking about hormones is to look at your nutrition. So we talked about calories in versus calories out, but did you know that different types of foods or calories change your body's hormonal response? For example, high starch and high carbohydrate foods increase in insulin response. Insulin is a storage hormone. So you wanna make sure that you're balancing your insulin levels so you're not storing crazy amounts of fat, but also, you know, so that your body is able to burn fat and to release fat to be burnt, right? So insulin comes along with your nutrition. Also, protein and fiber. Protein and fiber are big things to focus on because in your body, via hormones, they release things that tell your body that you're full. So protein and fiber release hormones that give you feelings of satisfaction and fullness, and they reduce cravings. BCAAs are another great weapon to help with that hormonal balance. And then, of course, lifestyle factors, like I mentioned, sleep, stress, all of these things matter. So there are lots of kind of science and geeky hormonal informational tips and tricks and stuff in the members portal. So you can log in and look at that. But I just wanted to address your question and give you some of the basics, the big rocks for how to balance your fat burning hormones. I hope that helps. If you have any more questions about that, definitely post here in the group and I will make sure that we answer everything we can and we get you all set for a healthy, happy, and balanced life.